Good morning, students. Today I am going to continue chapter number 2, From Trade to Territory from History. And today I will discuss two topics to you. Number 1 is how trade led to battles, and number 2 is the Battle of Plassey. Okay? So, my dear students, as I told you in my previous explanation, before the starting of 18th century, Britishers came in India only for trade and business. But time is moving and they requested and demanded for the expansion of trade and business from the rulers who were ruled over the country. Slowly, slowly, their demand was started towards the fortification of area where they were settled, and they wanted to make army for the protection of the company's officials and their trade and business. In this way, in topic number 1, I will discuss with you that how the purpose of trade led to battles. So, as I told you that from the starting of 18th century, conflict between the company and Nawab of Bengal was started, and it was just happened after the death of Aurangzeb. After the death of Aurangzeb, finally, as I told you, many strong Nawabs and commanders of Mughal Empire divided territory into the number of parts, and they started rule over there. In this way, Bengal Nawabs gained too much power and autonomy and became the Nawab of Bengal. After the formation of Bengal as a separate territory, Murshid Quli Khan, after that Ali Wardi Khan, and after that Sirajuddaula became the Nawab of Bengal. And each three Nawabs were a strong ruler because they refused to permit the company for the concession, for the taxes, and whatever British demanded for the large tribute for the company's right for trade. And these three Nawabs also rejected and refused whatever they wanted, like Britishers wanted to fortify their area, they wanted to make a fort to keep their products and officials, and also for their saving. But these three Nawabs refused their demand and also claimed that, it means these three Nawabs claimed on British company that they were responsible to reduce the revenue of Bengal, whatever they had earned from the trade and business. Because as I told you that Bengal Nawab received revenue or taxes on the goods and services whatever taken by the traders from one country to another country from crossing the part of Calcutta or now Kolkata. Alright? So, finally, these three Nawabs refused to give this kind of opportunity to the Britishers. In just response, British company officials also refusing and completely denied to pay tax to the Bengal Nawab, and also writing disrespectful letters and trying to humiliate and dominate the Nawab and its officials. Alright? Finally, due to the unjust demand of British and British company were responsible for the loss of profit related to the local traders also, because you know very well that everywhere Britishers wanted more and more profit. That's why they had started dominating the local rulers to give products in very cheap price. In this way, they also were responsible for the loss of Bengal revenue and loss profit, who was British officer. In this way, finally, in front of the Bengal Nawab had a great challenge to stop Britishers. Alright? Finally, this dissatisfaction and misunderstanding and these clashes were responsible for the Battle of Plassey. Okay? So students, story will start from here, and we have to understand that how Battle of Plassey was started. So students, after the death of Nawab Sirajuddaulah, and when Ali Wardi Khan died in 1756, Sirajuddaulah became the Nawab of Bengal, but he was also very great ruler and Nawab. And Britishers were well known that never Sirajuddaulah will be agree to pass all these above demand, whatever I had discussed to you in topic number one today. And Britishers wanted a kind of ruler who will work according to the wish of British. That's why whenever Britishers again raised their voice to pass the demand, whatever they wanted, Sirajuddaulah also denied all those demands. And finally, to stop the British officials, finally, Sirajuddaulah asked the company to stop meddling, and also Sirajuddaulah asked the company to stop interference in the Bengal political matters or affairs. And also Sirajuddaulah asked to British officers for the stop fortification and pay the revenues whatever fixed by the Bengal government. But again, British officers completely denied the request of Sirajuddaulah. Then, in response, Nawab Sirajuddaulah marched with 30,000 soldiers to the English factory, which was settled down at Kasima Bazaar, and there Nawab Sirajuddaulah had captured the company officials and locked the warehouse or the storage of the British company, and also disarmed or taken by all the arm and ammunition from the Englishmen, and also blocked an English ship. Then Sirajuddaulah marched to Calcutta to establish control over the companies fought there, where Britishers already fortificated the entire area where they were lived and where they were busy in trade and business. So students, for today's that's all. In my next explanation, I will continue the another incident related to the Battle of Plassey, and I will discuss with you that how and why Sirajuddaulah defeated by the Britishers in the Battle of Plassey. All right. Thank you and have a nice day.